Let's start adding up the balance sheet of what we in the Army Service Forces have accomplished since December 7, 1941. This was the moment of resolution. This was the signal for unity to the 135 millionth power. We had been working before, working against opposition to prepare the country and its army. But now this meant the green light for the Army Supply Services. The green light that meant also the gravest of responsibilities, the most difficult of jobs. And on December 7 began a record of achievement of which we can all well be proud. 100,000 volunteers, 1 million and then another 1 million enlisted men. Send them to us. We'll build the camps and we'll staff them and make them machines for living. We're ready for them. This is what we've been planning for. And now we're ready to move. We won't be caught unprepared. We had to learn how to take care of them, nurse them, insure them against the tropical and polar diseases they'll have to face. We had to work out systems of figuring what was their best job. And always we had to feed them, fill their bellies with good food, too. And we faced the monumental job of getting them the tools for their fighting. Designing those tools, testing them, making those tools, mass making them, financing their manufacture and buying them, and finally, making sure they get to the men who need them, whether for training or for fighting. And we got the job done faster than possible, because our need was the most urgent the world has ever known. We had to get the tools to where they would do the most good. That, too, was our job, and a big one. Lend-lease in the billions of dollars worth. Little things like quinine. Big things like trucks. Or still bigger like 50-ton tanks. Allies desperately pressed, holding valiantly, holding time still for us. And the ASF must get to them, as well as to our own men, the tools they need. The men of the ASF, they never learned how important was this part of their job. It's too bad, but we were too busy to tell them. And still, the most important job we had was training our own men. The time that the Chinese and the Russians and the British saved for us saved the lives of these boys, because we were doing our part by getting them the tools they needed to learn their job, and by teaching them how to use these tools. We reached out over the seas and through the air to bring the vital supplies to a dozen new strange theaters of operation. And where there was no existing way to move in our supplies, where there was no line of communications, we sent in our engineers, and they made our line for us where none had existed before. And the goods got where they were needed, landed in 50 strange places. We were learning geography the hard way. Guadalcanal, Attu, Accra, Casablanca, Chongqing, Kiska, Cairo, Algiers, Sicily. Within a few scant months of December 7, our ASF had ferried our American soldiers to Ireland and Alaska, to Trinidad and South America, to Egypt, China and India. But our ASF enlisted men never got a picture of what we were accomplishing. We were too busy accomplishing it to tell them. And so within a few scant months of December 7, we were on the attack on Guadalcanal. Within 11 months, hundreds of thousands of American troops had landed on the shores of North Africa and were beginning to use millions of tons of shipping. Before the end of the African campaign, these men were to use more equipment and supplies than we sent to France in the whole of World War I. The ASF had been given a responsibility. It was discharging that responsibility with honor and dispatch. The job we have done and will continue to do is justifiably a matter of pride for us, but it must also be a matter of pride for the enlisted men in our command. And this is not the case. For while the job of things was getting done, the job with people was being neglected. At home and abroad, the rank and file private, who is the Army, flops himself down on the ground and beefs. And do you know what he beefs about? What he thinks of his job, his officers, his Army, and his cause? Here's a very quick look into the mind of the average private.